Hello everyone and welcome to Easy Wi-Fi channel. I'm Kevin Yazdi and today we want to show how to integrate ICE and a Cisco switch in order to tag access notification. Some ICE configuration was down in wireless LAN controller and ICE integration part 1. Please watch it. For reminding, in part 1, two users with two different access groups was added into ICE local database. Two tag access profile for read-only and read-write access was created as well. In part 3 today, at first we have a glance at ICE existence configuration, then switch will be added and a new policy will be created in ICE. Then we move to switch, add ICE as a tag access server, add tag access server group, method list, and finally test and tshot. Both ICE and wireless and switch are in the same subnet. Let's start to check the existence ICE configuration that we already done. We add two local user to check administration, identity management, and identity. Here we have a lab admin and lab operator. Lab admin is a member of the group lab read write, and lab operator is a member of lab read only group. Also, we create a network device group, administration, network resource, network device groups. In all device type, we have a switch and wireless already created. Now we want to add a new switch to the ICE. We go to the administration, network resource, and network device. And click add. Put the name and IP address here. Device type, we add it to the switches and we click on the tag access authentication setting, shared secret Cisco 1234, same we will done on the switch, and submit. Good. Now we're moving to policy, work center, device administration, policy element, result, and we have a two tag access profile to limit access and manage access to the switches. In tag access profile, we assign the right privilege level. We already created a lab read-only profile with privilege 5. Check. And lab read write profile with privilege 15. Excellent. Nice. Going to the device admin policy set, and here we want to create a new policy set. Click on add, put a name, wire, tag X, condition. Device type, switch, use. Allow it protocol, default network admin is good, and we have to save to can move forward. Excellent. Click here. And in authentication policy, we have a default. It checks the users in all stores, but we can make it narrow, just the internal user. And options, authentication fail, reject. If user not found, reject. If process fail, drop, is good. No need to change, just leave it. And we just need to add to authorization policy here. Click add, new role, read only. User condition identity group internal user identity group, and we choose lab read only. Shell profile lab read only profile, and one more for read and write. Read, write, condition, identity group, internal user identity group, and read, write. Nice, excellent. And the shell profile is lab read and write profile. Save. We're done with the ICE setting, and now we move to the switch configuration. In switch configuration, we need to put some CLI command. At first, we should enable SSH. If it's not enabled on the switch, IP domain name and crypto key as regular. And we add the ICE as a tagx server, put the replay new model, obviously tagx server tag one is the name we assign to the ICE, and we put the ICE IP address here. Then we create the tagx group, AAA group server tagx plus, and we put the name tag g for the tagx group, and we assign our ICE to this group. If we have more ICE standby active, we need to add the new also the standby ICE server here. And finally, we add method list. AAA authentication login default group tag, then local, and AAA authorization exec default group tag G, and then local, and also accounting exec default start stop group tag G. That's it. Let me copy and paste command on our switch. Okay, excellent. Now we check. Okay. Lab admin password. Excellent. With full access, and one for the next. Tap operator password and check that. No access. It will limit access for LAN operator. And one need more just to do some error. Now we move to the ICE and check the logs, operation, tagx, live logs. The last was a wrong check. What was wrong? It was fail. Deny access because the user K1 is not belong to one of these group read only and read write. And we check the lab operator. Authorization pass and lots of useful information, especially for troubleshooting. Also the signal transfer between the ice and switch. Excellent. Review the command one time more. At first we enable SSH, then we add ice as a tagx server. We create a tagx group and then we add the method list. Thank you for watching. Please let me know your comments to improve coming videos. And don't forget to subscribe Easy Wi-Fi channel to watch new Easy Config videos. Thank you.